Well, I mean, these are amazing times, and in order for us to wake up, we need a wake up call. And if you can frame the circumstances to see that it's an opportunity for everybody to pause and retreat from their lives, and by removing the constant stimulation in their external environment that reminds them of who they think they are as a personality, they're not going to the same places, they're not seeing the same people, they're not doing the same things, and they're actually confined to kind of a personalized retreat in the comfort of their own home. Now, the beauty behind this is who you're going to emerge as. And sure, the conditions in our environment are causing us to be uncertain. And in uncertainty, when things we can't predict certain things, we move from everything that's predictable and known to this realm called the unknown. And if we're truly going to make a difference in the world, we have to be creative. The problem is that when we're threatened by circumstances in our external environment, our response to those circumstances causes us to move into a very primitive state, a response from the autonomic nervous system that drives the body into what's called a sympathetic response, a fight or flight response. So in that emergency mode, the brain and the body go into an alarmed state because there's a threat or a danger that we're perceiving in our outer environment. Now, for the short term, that's okay because all organisms can cope with short-term stress. But if our response to the environment is keeping that stress response going on for an extended period of time, stress is when the brain and body are knocked out of homeostasis. Stress is when the brain and body are knocked out of balance. So people, when they react to circumstances that are unpredictable, that are uncertain, that they can't control an outcome, or they have the perception that things are going to get worse, it's the exact motive that turns on that fight or flight response. So now when the person's living in fear, they're mobilizing enormous amounts of energy for some danger in their outer world. Now, there's only a certain amount of energy in the body, and if there's no energy in the inner environment for growth and repair, we become more susceptible to the conditions in our outer environment. In other words, our response in fear and aggression and frustration and pain and suffering actually weakens the organism. So now, in these times, we have to become conscious about our relationship with our body. We have to become aware that we are amazing human beings that come fully loaded with an immune system that combats bacteria and viruses, cancer cells, funguses and molds that happen on a moment-to-moment basis. And so let's just say that in your normal life, you're reacting to the traffic, you're reacting to your coworkers, you're reacting to the news, and your response to any one of those circumstances in your outer environment causes you to feel some of those limited emotions. So anything that's controlling you, or you have no control over, you are, or think you have no control over, you are a victim to your environment. And it is that consciousness that causes us to become more susceptible to anything in our outer environment. And so the immune system becomes compromised, the internal system of our internal environment that's responsible for metabolism, assimilation, growth and repair. So our research shows that, well, first of all of our training, all of our work that we've done, everybody that's listening to this show is looking for answers because they believe that there is more to reality than this dream. And it's an instinct that we have that never seems to go away. And that feeling that sometimes is difficult to describe has brought people to search for greater information, for greater truth. And so the relationship that we have with our body tells us that when people understand that change is to be greater than their body, to be greater than the conditions in their environment, and to be able to sustain that type of change for an extended period of time, then all of the training, all of our practice, all of our meditations, all of our transformation, all of our awareness is for times like these. This is where now we have to apply everything we've learned. This is, we're out of the bleachers now, and we're on the playing field. So our research shows that, yeah, fear and those stress hormones actually suppress the immune response. But if people understood how powerful their immune system really is, that if they traded that fear for gratitude, and I know that there's may not be a whole lot of things to be grateful for, but if you live in survival, you see limited possibilities, because in stress and in survival, you will begin to select scenarios in your mind to prepare for the worst thing that could happen. Now, that's a kind of a limited imagination, but if you trade that emotional state for an elevated emotion like love or wholeness or inspiration or gratitude or thankfulness, our research shows that by converting from that sympathetic nervous system and teaching the body that it's safe in the present moment and beginning to activate elevated emotions, if you just practice that for 10 minutes a day for 2 or 3 times a day, that your immune system will strengthen by 50%. That's a significant amount of change. Now, that's saying that once you activate this center called your heart center, your center of oneness, your center of wholeness, the union of opposites, this is where we begin to create from. This is when we're in a state of creation, we're seeing possibilities that we've never seen before. Now we're no longer victims to our environment. We're now coming up with solutions that cause us to respond in greater ways to our environment. That once energy makes it to the center, that little gland that sits right next to your heart, called the thymus gland. Thymus mean time, like a time leaf. Has two functions. It has a endocrinological function, which makes growth hormone, which is the fountain of youth. That's what causes a response and repair quickly in the body and regeneration. And then it has an immunological function, and it releases a chemical called thymosin. And when activated, thymosin signals T cells, your elite force in your body. And T cells have receptors on the outside of their cells that have to be activated. And when you're feeling gratitude or love, it's a time for growth and repair. And the emotion then is what begins to select and instruct different genes and activate these T cell receptors that cause the T cell to actually be able to become powerful or empowered against foreign agents, viruses, bacterias, molds, even cancer cells. So by moving into a state of balance, you're strengthening your inner environment. These T cells can actually combat the very foreign agents from our environment. And it's happening right now. It's happening for us right now. Our immune system is memorizing foreign agents on a moment-to-moment basis. But if you're living in fear, and the chemical response to your environment is saying it's dangerous or threatening out there, then those chemicals actually shut down the T receptor sites, because it needs energy for the emergency in the outer environment. So we become more susceptible to foreign agents in our inner environment. So when the receptors are stimulated, in order for the body to produce antibodies or immunoglobulins, proteins, a gene has to be signaled. So it's the chemical state of wholeness and gratitude that's saying that it's safe enough to relax into the present moment, and now there's growth and repair going on. The chemical signal then activates the receptors. The receptors activate the gene. The gene makes a protein called an immunoglobulin, and immunoglobulin A is your primary defense against bacteria and viruses. And our research shows 4 days is going to increase that chemical by 50%. And those antibodies are Y-shaped proteins that actually stop the receptors from a virus or a bacteria from attacking it. So now there's an elite force of T cells that's made right from your thymus gland. When energy and blood flow makes it in there, there's a host of physiological changes that begin to take place that causes you to become more immune to the conditions in your environment. So I think it's important for people to understand that they're not limited, that only if they believe that something out there is going to get them. The stronger the fear that we have, the more we put our attention on the cause, and where we place our attention is where we place our energy. So in a sense, We're giving our vitality, our very energy to change and heal.